Hey guys, hi, happy weekend. I am Jill with Click to Restore and I am live on the Dixie Belle Paint Company page. Thank you for joining in. I just want to make sure that everything is working right here on Facebook. So today we are going to be doing chalk paint pour. I know you have heard about paint pour, resin paint pour, but I will not be doing the resin paint pour. I will be doing the chalk paint pour today with you all, okay? So see ya, hi, let me know where you're watching from. I am based in McKinney, Texas, and I will be showing you how to do a chalk paint pour, and it's more economical, it's easier. So, hey Rosie, hey Valerie. So, hey CJ, so nice to see you all here. So, this is what I am going to just move the camera a little bit down. Hey guys, it's messy. Let's see. So, this is the dresser that I will be working on with you today, the top. I have sanded it down, okay? This is sanded down, and on the base, what I have done is I've covered this with a shrink wrap, this one. This is all covered in shrink wrap. I've kept a plastic trash bag on the base, and I've just used this trim. It's 24 inch, and I bought this from Amazon, and I've lined it on the top. So there is a tape here, you see? It's all taped here and falling down. So when I do a paint pour here, it's not gonna mess up my dresser. Though it's not painted, so I don't care, but just if you are already painted your piece and you want to, you know, do a paint pour later, it's all fine. Hey, Jackus. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you what products I'm using and we'll start doing the paint pour, okay? So first of all, as I start putting my supplies here, I want to tell you about the initial steps. Cover this with a plastic shrink wrap. The top, if the top is painted, what will happen is it will be difficult to move the paint around. So make sure you just sand your piece and it's ready to go, okay? And these are the colors that I'll be using on today. I hope I am visible to you all. And I will just move you closer so I can show you what I'm gonna do. Hey, Jody. So today I am working with Dixie Belle Fluff, okay? I'm using Savannah Mist, and I'm using Moonshine Metallics in silver, okay? It is silver bullet. This is what I'm using. I hope there is someone from Dixie Belle to answer any questions as they come along. I think Natalia is here. Natalia is here, okay. So she will be answering any questions that you may have. As we go on, if you are joining in between and you want to know what colors I am using, like I said, I mentioned on the blur above, so you will know. You can just go and read the colors that I'm using on this piece today, okay? So it's Fluff, Savannah Mist, and Silver Bullet. These are the three colors I'm using, and we are going to do a chalk paint pour. No resin, just water and Dixie Belle paints. So as you're tuning, say hi. Let me know where you're watching from. We love to hear where our followers, our fans are from, okay? So you can see my face because I want to focus here. And I will be answering questions later on. So you need 3 cups, one for each color, okay? You need 3 spoons to mix the colors. And you need water. Just clear, simple, plain water. So we are going to work on the consistency to do the chalk paint pour. So the consistency has to be similar to milk, okay? Plain milk. So I'm going to be focusing more on the white on the top, so I will be using more of Fluff. So I will pour the paint in here, okay? So I put my paint here. Now I'll take water. Am I visible or need to move it forward? Okay, is it better? I think so. Just give me a thumbs up and let me know if the... Hey, Chastity. So I will put water in this. Half and half, okay? Not the coffee half and half. Just have water and half paint, okay? And I'm going to just stir this nicely. Looking forward, yay! So I'm just going to stir this nicely so that the paint and water mix and blend in together really well. And see, it's already looking like a milk. So just the colors, water, a spoon to mix, and a heat gun or a hair dryer to move the paint around. So this is what I'm gonna do after I do the paint pour. So is the consistency fine? Yes, it's absolutely. Look, it's just like milk. So this is the consistency that you need for this pour. I want to add a little bit of Savannah Mist. Why? Because I'm painting the base with Savannah Mist. So I want to add a little bit of Savannah Mist. So make sure you have enough paint before you start working on the project. Why? Because if you run out of the paints while you are doing this, you're going to mess up the project. So I will just see. My paint is this much, and I'm going to add the same amount of water. I take a separate spoon and I'm gonna mix this paint again. I mean, the prep takes a little bit of time, but trust me, once you pour the paint and you work on it, it'll take like 2 or 3 minutes and you'll be done with your project. So just hang on there, okay? Just stay with me and we will see some magic happening. And because I know that you have paints sitting at home, right? You have Dixie Belle paints. So it's, you don't have to go anywhere to do this technique. You can just pull this paint out and do the paint pour. Okay, so this is Savannah Mist done. I wanna add a little bit of silver bullet, because I'm going to paint the hardware silver. So I want a hint of silver, okay? So let me pour some silver bullet. Okay. I think I'm done, so I'm gonna move this away and we will just start on doing the paint pour. I think I will add a little water because steel magnolia, this is a metallic paint and it's already thin. I will not add too much of water. I would say 70-30, that should be the consistency. Water should be just 30%, and see, I think it's good enough because I don't want it to flow too much. Okay, let's do this. I hope we don't run out of paint. Fingers crossed, okay? It's kind of scary, but. So plastic is there on the base, plastic is there on the dresser. Don't worry about the drips. Let it drip, let it flow. And we are going to be using the paper towels. I have a big roll with me, and we are going to wipe it off if any mess happens, okay? The first thing you do the paint pour, and you pick the dryer up. I want to say that, I want to come on the camera and say that. When you pick the hair dryer or the heat gun, just pray to Lord that your hair dryer doesn't stop in between, because if it does, I mean, the project is just disaster, okay? So good luck, let's start doing this. Okay, let me move these spoons out. And let me move this spoon out. And one by one, I'm gonna pour this and we are going to see what's gonna happen, okay? I'm just making room so that it goes on fine. So first paint I'm going to pour is Fluff, okay? What was the first color? Fluff, Savannah Mist, and Steel Magnolia. So let's do this. Am I nervous? Yes, I am. And it's very normal. Okay, so let's do this. So remember, I said I want more of white. So that's why I'm focusing more on white. And it's a random way of just pouring the paint. Don't worry about it. It's not gonna dry until unless you put the heat gun on it, on this. Gun sounds so funny. I live in Texas and everyone owns a gun here. So let's say a heat dryer, okay? Now I'm gonna pour some Savannah Mist. I can put it on top of Fluff even, or I can just put it on wood. Totally up to you, okay? So you saw I didn't use a lot of paint, so don't worry about wasting paint. It's more of water. I don't think it's 4 ounces of paint even I used on this project, because someone said it's a lot of waste and I don't see that. So I'm going to be putting on the trim here little by little. Don't rush on pouring the paint, okay? I will pour a little bit of Steel Magnolia here now. I want those nice waves here. It doesn't look good, right? But just hold on, it'll look nice. So it's just a random pattern, nothing to plan or anything. And I did a live on my page. There is a tutorial on this on my Facebook channel, and I have shared a picture with you. Okay, so this is done. Let's take the heat gun now. Okay, I have the heat gun here and the paint is poured. It's all ready. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna do this, okay? Oops. No. See, I said pray before you use this hair dryer. Okay. I want to tell you that the setting of this is high and on heat, okay? Okay, this is the crafts brush that I'm gonna use, and I'm gonna just drag the paint here. I can pour it, but I don't want to do that. I can just mix it up here, see, and you won't even come to know because the paint consistency is thin. I'm gonna fix this side up. Just give me a sec, okay? I can hear the drips and it's falling down, but I have secured it with the plastic so I don't have to worry. So it's done. See how quick it was. And when you are using, please use this brush because it doesn't leave any of the marks. It looks so natural. Okay, done. Oh, okay. We are done, we are done. Let me get it closer and show you how it looks like, okay? Did you see that? Absolutely fabulous. Yay, Sally. Okay, you guys can see it, how it's coming out, right? I can just pull you a little bit down and show you the mess here. So the paint is gonna pour, and these I'm not gonna worry about. But if you want, you can just keep on moving the hair dryer and it's gonna drip. But I plan to paint the edges. So what I'm gonna do is, I will take this tissue paper towel here, and I'm going to wipe this because I'm going to paint this anyways, so I don't want it to be hanging here. So I'm just going to take this and wipe it off. See, I just wiped it. So let me show you, let me pull you, now you can see it better. So can you see that cloudy, that wavy marble kind of a look? So you can still see steel magnolia, the waves here, right? You can see Savannah Mist blending into the fluff, and it's not dirty anyway. It didn't go to my floor, on my floor. I know it's just on the plastic, and I'm going to take these gloves off now because I finished painting. I've done the paint pour, guys. It looks fabulous, right? It looks like a marble, right? It does. I know, and I can see, let me get it closer, okay? See now, see this. Can you see steel magnolia here? Steel magnolia here. You can see the waves created with Savannah Mist and fluff, and it looks so natural. And it's covered the entire top. You see this? So, I showed you all these steps on how you have to keep the consistency of this paint pour project. What's the consistency you need to have? And 50% water and 50% paint. And you can put any colors you like. So if you remember, I did a project, and in that it was a coffee bean and different kind of colors. So It just so like quickly, and she loves it. So my second part on this project is going to be sealing it. Now, the question usually comes is, are you going to pour resin on it? No, I'm not going to pour resin on it for two reasons. The first reason is resin is expensive compared to another top coat. And second, I don't want to seal it with a top coat, which will be difficult down the lane for another painter to take off. So I know resin is a thick layer, and if I put it on here, I mean, it will be very difficult for anyone to remove that layer of resin and again repaint this dresser. So I'm gonna be sealing it with lacquer, and I will be doing it live on my page on Monday. And why I'm saying Monday is because this chalk paint takes 24 to 48 hours to dry completely. It will completely dry in a matte, like a chalky paint kind of a finish, like Dixie Belle paint dries. But when you put the top coat in lacquer, it's gonna shine. So I will be doing three coats of lacquer on this top, and it will be done. And from my experience also, I'm saying that one of my clients came and she said that she has a resin top and it just cracked on a few spots. Can you fix that? I said, no, I can't. And she picked a few colors like greens from Dixie Belle, and she's like, just to touch up. I said, I can't do that because resin is a thick layer, and touching it up means just spoiling that. So it will be very difficult to do that. So, nope. What is the YouTube? You can go to Click to Restore, you can find on YouTube, and I have a paint pour tutorial on that. What kind of lacquer? I think it's a Minwax. If you want, you can tune in noon CST, 11 a.m. EST, Easter, and I will be sealing this live on my page. That is Click to Restore. Do you coat with a clear? No, I won't be using the best dang wax. I will be using lacquer. Off topic, but what do you have your cart lined with? Oh, my cart? This is everything. My paintbrushes, gloves, wipes, tape, scissors, screwdrivers, everything. On the lower two, my Big Mama's butter, I mean, there, everything. On this, in the center, all these screwdrivers and everything, tapes and everything. And on the top, I usually keep my paints, and this is handy dandy when I'm working around in this area. So you can see the piece I did a black wash on just a week before, it's there. I did a white wash on this, and that's a winter sewing table. I've used Savannah Mist in that too. So this is typically my staging area as well. Could you coat it with the, yes, you can, absolutely you can do that. But yes, I want it to be shiny, so I will be doing it with the lacquer. But before the lacquer, you can put a coat of Dixie Belle Gatorade because it's water resistant and water repellent. So you can put one coat of Gatorade and then go over and put lacquer. I hope I'm able to answer so many of your questions. Yes, it's so easy. And that's why I decided that I can come on live on the Dixie Belle Paint Company page and show you that it is easy to do a paint pour. It's not at all difficult. And you can use just Dixie Belle chalk paints and create a beautiful top, right? And I know many of you watching here, you have chalk paint at home, right? And if you don't have, I mean, I've left the link above. You can just go order, or you can find your closest retailer. And don't forget to join our Facebook group. And I've left the link above for that too. So many inspirations, so many good projects, everyone shares there. So what kind of lacquer? I answer, I know, what will you do with the front and sides? So yes, Soli, this is your question and I should answer here. So I'm going to be putting woody vent moldings on the front because it's a French provincial. I'm sorry, I can't show you right now, but it's a French provincial dresser with three drawers and it has these French provincial pulls here. So I will be adding moldings on this piece, woody vent molding, which you can also buy from the link that I've left on top on the blur. You can order from there or find the closest retailer. So I will be putting the woody vent moldings here and painting it in Savannah Mist and a little bit of fluff. And that's what I'm gonna do with this piece. So I'm glad you like it. Too much of glare, right? Too much of glare. I should stand this side and answer your question. Can you see it now? Okay. So any more questions, I should go back and answer here because it's very difficult to go back after the live to answer questions. I mean, I can't scroll up. Facebook doesn't let me see the... I answered that question. It takes 24 to 48 hours to dry mess is controlled. You see, I just did it here and it's dripped down on the base, but my room is as clean. Look, just a few drips here and it's fine. I mean, it's not going under my dresser because it's all plastic underneath the legs, so I know it's not gonna there. And if you're worried about this, let's do this. You see this extra plastic here? Just lift this dresser and, okay, just turn it in. Fold the plastic and put it under the leg so you know that your paint is not going on there. Okay, so the mess is controlled. Yes, the mess is absolutely controlled. What do the you do the best paint part? So thank you, Jackis. You're so sweet. I love to see you on my page. And I told I'm going to be sealing it with Dixie Belle Gatorade one coat and then lacquer. And I told what colors I use. If you want to go back, you can check the blurb. I have mentioned the colors, the three colors: Fluff, Savannah Mist, and Silver Bullet. So I have answered the questions, right? Okay. So yes, I have answered most of the questions. I go back later on to see if what will you do on the edge of the marble. Like I said, it was dripping. So what I did is I took a paper towel and just wiped it because I don't want it to drip on the side. It's a flat edge. I will going to be painting this and I will be using Silver Bullet to do the trim. So little sparkle, but just muted and nice and looks nice and goes well together. Hey from Texas, hey Rhonda. I'm in Texas too. Would you seal kitchen counter? I wouldn't do that because, kitchen counter, you wanna eat food and you don't want to use lacquer on that. So yes, I wouldn't do that, but it's great for furniture. It looks absolutely beautiful. And because I know, because I did already nightstand and my client loves that, loves those nightstands. So I know that this piece will be loved too wherever it goes. So thank you so much guys for tuning in and I hope this was helpful. And it's very thin, Sheila, it's very thin. If you watch the replay, you can see the consistency of the paint. It's exactly like the consistency of the milk. So thank you so much, guys, and God bless you all. Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.